So, first off, to clear up any confusion, there are three ways that the term nu metal is used. One, as a derogatory term for quote-unquote bad metal. Two, as a broad label for late 90s and early 2000s rock music, particularly that of a hard rock or alternative persuasion. And three, Korn is nu metal and embody it entirely. Number one is pretty worthless as a label. I have heard Lamb of God and Trivium referred to as nu metal in this sense. And even by the second definition, this is a bit of a stretch. Metal elitists just want a catch-all term to dismiss things, and nu metal just fits this purpose. This is probably the most useless of the three definitions, as anything from Faith No More to Gojira can be lumped into this label. To the elitist, if it's not death metal, black metal, Slayer, or Judas Priest, it's nu metal. Number two is a slightly better term, but still lacking. This nu metal definition is loose, like classic rock or heavy metal, in that it may include various subgenres under one umbrella. In this case, rap metal, alternative metal, post-grunge, industrial metal, and often bands that mix styles, such as hard rock and metalcore, for example. However, nu metal is most often conflated with rap metal, but they are different. Rap metal predates nu metal, and goes back to Anthrax, who decided to take their crossover thrash sound and rap over it. This is undoubtedly rap metal, but would never be called nu metal. Likewise, Attila raps over deathcore, and is once again distinct from nu metal in the true sense. Also, nu metal seldom features rapping, anyway. The third and final definition is what I think of as the true one. Korn is the template of nu metal. It has a distinct style, a raw one. If I had to reduce it to three specific bare parts, they are groove metal, think Pantera and their chunky guitar riffs, grunge, think Nirvana and their angsty attitude, and thirdly, hip-hop. Quite possibly the earliest development in nu metal is the band Prong. Despite being a thrash metal band, they are quite experimental, making them a proto-alternative metal, and even a proto-nu metal band. You can hear all the elements that I mentioned on display here. Groove metal, grunge, and hip-hop. Korn took influence from Prong, and ended up truly creating nu metal. You don't know the chances. I'm so blind. Two key elements present in Korn's music that is lacking in many bands lumped in with nu metal are the turntables and the beatboxing. Now, Korn is pretty much the only band that seems to do the metal beatboxing thing, so I guess by my standards, they are the only nu metal band. But perhaps that's too limiting. The lyrical themes of true nu metal typically involve youth, trauma, and poverty. And when I say poverty, I don't mean strictly economically. I mean poverty of soul, poverty of intimacy, a general sense of lacking. Nu metal can be pretty immature, but it can also be quite dark. Very dark, in fact. Whatever you think of nu metal, it's quite insulting that it gets lumped in with this, considering how tonally different they are. Feeling cold, going blind, free as hell, doing time. I'm insane, can't complain, flush you turds down the drain. The tales of abuse in some of the tracks are really hard to listen to. It's uncomfortable, and honestly more disturbing than some of the more extreme metal bands when they actively try to be disturbing. One major thing that adds to the uneasy feeling of nu metal is the subversion of childhood innocence. Korn's iconic first album cover is that of a creepy shadow looming over a playground while a girl sits in a swing. Korn's name also features a backwards R, reminiscent of the R in Toys R Us, and is misspelled with a K rather than a C. This gives the feeling that their name itself was written by a disturbed child. I mentioned in the rap metal video that rap metal feels like a parody of hood culture. So if rap metal is comedy, then nu metal is tragedy, the other side of the coin, the dark side of the ghetto. It is less so cultural cringe, and more so a genuine expression of angst and disillusionment with urban living and modern society. Korn's first two albums are probably the purest examples of nu metal, as even they slightly departed from the sound later on. Flirting with funk metal, alternative metal, even experimenting with dubstep at one point. Their newer stuff has taken on a prog dimension as well. Jonathan Davis, the singer, also embraces his heritage by wearing kilts and playing bagpipes. So clearly, the genre does not have the same message as rap metal. Some other bands that have played authentic nu metal are Slipknot, Show me your heart. Mudvayne, and OTEP. I hope you now understand what nu metal truly is. If you were expecting to hear about bands like 3 Days Grace, Evanescence, and System of a Down, or want to hear them discussed, perhaps I will do so in another video. I'm always down for genre or meme topic suggestions, so feel free to make a comment. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time.